families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 Rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 Rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
How y'all doing? Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. How y'all doing? How's everybody? I appreciate that. Thank y'all. I appreciate it, everybody. Well, welcome to Family Feud, South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Well, been back in South Africa for a few weeks now, having a wonderful time. I love y'all. I love your country. I love us. I love my people. Yeah. Yeah. So we're gonna have a great show today. Let me explain to you how the show works. We've had our researchers. They have been out on the streets of Mzansi. Yeah. They have been asking you for some answers to some very, very simple questions. And we've got these answers locked in the board. The family that answers the most questions, accumulates the most points by the end of the game, will have a chance to compete for the grand jackpot of 75,000 Rand. Yeah. Well, let's get it on and meet the families. From the East Rand, it's the MOFOKENG family. Yeah! And they're playing against from Niger, it's the MALGAS family. Yeah! Well, if you're ready for the show to get started, everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
Give me my sepo. Yeah! Anthony. Matsepo. Pronounce it.
Matepo.
Matepo.
Yes, close.
Oh, tep.
Tepo.
Tepo.
Yeah.
Matepo.
Matepo.
What? Am I pissing you off?
No, you're not.
Because I'm trying to get in and she keeps. Every time I say it, she make a face. Every time I say it, she goes.
I'm so sorry.
I'm trying to get. Okay, one more time.
Matepo.
Matepo.
Okay, close.
What do you mean close? What?
Go, goats.
What?
Goats. And you go, Matepo.
Your name is Anthony.
I just thought I should.
He's helping.
What the hell is he talking to me for?
He's helping.
Anthony. I got four friends named Anthony. Do they call you Tony for short?
Yes. They do.
See that? I can say both of them.
Yep.
One more time.
Matepo.
Oh, se.
Yes.
Matepo.
Yeah!
Matepo. All right, welcome to the show.
Thank
y'all for coming.
Thank you.
Surveyed 100 people. We got top 7 answers on the board. Here we go. Name something people do to get someone's attention. Matepo.
They jump up in your face like, hello,
they jump
hello,
up
hello.
In your face. They get in your face. Yeah. Anthony.
What I do with Steve, they start ignoring you.
They start ignoring you. Table.
They call you?
They call you. Pass the plate.
We play. Okay,
they're gonna play.
Play.
Let's go. Matepo, what do
That's
you do for
it.
A living?
I'm a network marketer.
Network marketer.
Yes.
Okay, good. All right, cool. Introduce everybody.
Okay.
Fukeng. Rolling with the Fukeng. Yeah.
We have my sister Devu, we have my fabulous cousin.
Feku, Feku, Feku! Feku! Didn't quite. Feku, 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 Feku! Feku. What did you say?
Mofokeng. Our surname.
Say it again.
Mofokeng.
Mofokeng.
Yes.
I pronounced that right.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't hear you say. Oh, you were singing it.
Yes.
Mofokeng.
Mofokeng.
Mofokeng. Yay.
And then what was the last part?
Rolling with the Fukeng.
Oh, you rolling with the Fukeng. Oh, okay, I like that. Mofokeng, 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 rolling with the Mofokeng.
Yeah.
All right, now introduce yourself.
Okay, we have my sister Tebu, our fabulous cousin Matabo, and that's our nephew Tabo, and the last one is Siyabonga, our cousin.
Okay. Tebu, what do you do?
A learning consultant.
Learning consultant, okay.
Yes.
But Mtabu.
Matabu.
Matabu.
Yes.
But you got two M's.
Yes.
So I would makes me go, mmm. But you know, so you didn't really need the other M. See, Mtabu cause two M's. One M, Matabu. What do you do?
I'm a student. I'm a university student. I'm doing my last year, forensic
okay.
science.
What's your major?
Forensic science and technology.
Oh, forensic science.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, forensic.
That's do you know that's Forensic Files is my favorite TV show.
Yeah.
Forensic Files. I love forensic science.
Yeah.
That's good. All right, let's play. Name something people do to get someone's attention.
They send you 101 messages.
Yes.
They send you a lot of messages. Tabu, what do you do, man?
I'm currently studying hospitality. I'm the chef of the family.
Yeah.
Oh, you're a chef.
Yeah.
All right, this is good, man. Every night we've been going out, we've been eating at a different restaurant. They told me about this African restaurant with African cuisine. We're gonna go there today. What's your favorite dish to cook?
Mostly will be lasagna.
Lasagna?
Yeah.
Lasagna.
I come all the way to Africa to eat lasagna? You ain't cooking
I had my
like
own twist.
Kudu or nothing like that, dog? You just gonna make lasagna?
Yes, okay. With my own touch.
Oh, tell me what that is.
So I add, then using lasagna sheets,
uh-huh.
I use macaroni. And then I use mince, then I use cheese, then I use some cheese sauce, yeah, then bake it.
So
that's me.
Instead of using the sheets, you use macaroni?
Yes, the mac. And it's
mince,
damn good.
Mince is beef.
Yeah.
Yes.
Ground beef.
Yes.
Mince. Cheese. Well, that's everything that's in lasagna, except you don't use the sheets. You use macaroni.
Yes.
So you're just making a casserole.
Somebody.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that ain't lasagna. That's you making a macaroni casserole. But that's good, though. Congratulations, man.
Yeah.
Name something people do to get someone's attention.
Smack the person.
Smack a person. All right, my man. Woo. Siyabonga.
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 Yeah.
Okay, good. What do you do, man? Siyabonga.
I'm an entrepreneur.
An entrepreneur?
Yeah.
Like, what do you sell something?
I sell food.
You sell food? Oh, okay, I like that. That's good. Out on the street?
Yeah, on the street.
That's good. Like, what you sell?
Wings, burgers, quarters.
Oh, wings, burgers, quarters.
Yeah.
What is quarters? What is quarters? When you say quarters, what?
Quarter.
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 Yeah.
Quarter.
Yeah.
That's food.
Yeah, that's like chips, Russian, Vienna, bacon, yeah.
Bunny
all
chow.
In the mixed up?
Bunny
all
chow.
In the mixed up.
Bunny chow.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah I remember chow. That. Okay, good. All right, that's good. Congratulations, man. Keep hustling. Name something people do to get someone's attention.
They can write your name on a notice board.
They write their name on the...
Notice board?
Notice board. Oh, the notice board.
Yeah.
Oh, at your job.
Yay.
Okay, we got two strikes now. Y'all got to be careful. Y'all know these answers. You know how to get somebody's attention? Two strikes. The Malgas family can steal. Name something people do to get someone's attention.
Walk up in front of them naked.
Is that
all right now. know who you are, but I'm damn sure paying attention, though. Walk up in front of them naked. All right, Anthony, here we go. Name something people do to get someone's attention.
They'll whistle at you.
Whistle. Number six. Five.
Blood. Head on the ice.
Three.
Wave.
One.
Shout.
Well, we got a game. Mofonge family, not on the board. The Malgas family got 15. Don't go away, we'll be right back with the Feud. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Mofonging family not on the board. Malgas family got 15. Give me Tambo, give me El Marie. Ladies, we've got the top six answers on the board. Name an occupation that you typically associate with really smart people. Tambo.
Being a teacher.
Teacher. El Marie.
Doctors.
Doctors. Yes. Pass the play. Anthony, what do you do, man?
Steve, I'm a database administrator.
A what? A
database administrator in the bank.
Database administrator?
Yes.
Yes!
The thing.
Yeah.
This your real voice, dog? That's your real voice?
Thanks,
I didn't know what to. He scared me for a minute. I thought somebody was pushing him from behind. How long you been doing that, Anthony?
I've been doing it now for the past 9 years, Steve.
Knowing that past 9 years.
I'm gonna hear your voice all night long. I ain't gonna be able to sleep. No, that's good. That's good, man. I like you, man. How old are you, Anthony?
I'm 40. 39, turning 40, Steve.
Huh?
40. 40?
Oh, I thought you said 14. I just want to say, your ass is on drugs. 40. Oh, you look good, man. You look young.
No, no, thanks.
Wow,
thanks.
That's pretty good, man. All right, Anthony, introduce everybody.
Hi, Steve. On my right, I have my lovely wife. Her name is El Marie. Next to El Marie, I have my aunt. Her name is Jane. Next to Jane, I have a son. His name is Bradley. And on the other side, I have my cousin also. Her name is Grace.
Now, Bradley, who is Bradley again?
Bradley's my cousin.
One of your cousins.
And Jane's son.
Oh, okay. And that's Jane's son.
Yep.
Yes.
How did y'all meet? You and your wife, how did y'all
meet? At school, basically, Steve.
At school?
At school, yes.
Like college or high school? Or?
As in high school.
High school? You were high school sweethearts?
Yes. Yes.
High
school sweethearts.
All right, man, that was good. So what was it about her, man? When you saw her, what was it, Anthony? Come on,
to be
boy.
Honest, Mr. Harvey.
Yeah.
It was that kiss, the first kiss.
Yeah.
So it took me all the way. That kiss, the first kiss.
Huh? It was Anthony, it was everything.
Yeah, it was everything.
Everything. Woo! I got it, man. Y'all got any kids?
Yes, we have three lovely kids, two boys, one son. And then, sorry, Ms. Abby. We have one girl.
We have three lovely children, two boys, one son. Well, what's the other one? Yes. Y'all ain't quite figured that out yet. Three lovely children, two boys, one son.
I love.
Calm down.
I'm gonna leave that one alone. I don't know what happened. Hey, Jane, name an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
Scientist.
Yes. Bradley, give me an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
An accountant.
An accountant. Yeah! Grace, name an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
A lawyer.
Lawyer. Yeah! Give me an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
I would go, Steve, what? Software developer.
You gonna mess around and get one right. Software developer. We can clear the board. You have no strikes. El Marie, give me an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
It is... technicians. No, it's on the board, sorry.
Yes, on board. It's okay. Ah. Jane, give me an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
Professors.
The professor! We got two strikes now, Bradley. We need you to pull this one out. Be careful, they can steal. Name an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
I'm just gonna try and say this one. An artist.
An artist! All right, family, name an occupation you typically associate with really smart people.
Engineering.
Engineering! I like it! Engineering!
Good answer.
Well, that was round two, everybody. MOFOKENG Gang family got 84. The MALGAS family got 15. We got two good families playing Feud right now. We come back, we gonna double the points. So don't go away. We'll be back, Family Feud. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game now. MOFOKENG Gang family got 84. MALGAS family got 15. Give me Matabo.
Yeah. Yes.
Give me Jane. Yeah. All right, ladies, here we go. In this round, we're gonna double the points. We've got the top six answers on the board. Name a place where an oak would go chill with his mates.
At the bar.
At the bar. Yeah! Pass or play?
Play.
We're gonna play. Well, they had to come and explain to me because I didn't know what they was talking about. Oak. Table.
Table.
I said that once before. Same reaction. Table. Name a place where an oak would go chill with his mates.
Strip club.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
Boy, down at the strip club.
Yay.
All right, man, name a place where an oak would go chill with his mates.
At the park.
At the park. That was a good answer.
Yeah.
See, listen to me. You can give a good answer and not be on the board. Mm. When I was not famous, that's where I went with my boys, went to the park.
Yeah.
Famous, I can't go nowhere now. Where you go to your home? Where? In my backyard. That's it. All right, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. Mogul's family can steal. Name a place where an oak can go chill with his mates.
At the corner. Yeah. People chill at the corner.
Yeah.
Just at the corner.
Yeah.
Family, name a place where an oak will go chill with his mates.
At the stadium.
At the stadium. Number six.
Beach.
Five.
Golf course.
Three.
In the club.
Two.
Friday.
Well, that was round three, everybody. We got a real close one now. Mofoken Gang family got 84. Morgos family got 85. Wow, don't go away. After the break, we're gonna double the points. It's a good one now, folks. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Boy, we got a good one today. Mofoken Gang family got 84. Morgos family got 85. Give me Tabo. Give me Bradley. All right, here we go. In this round, points are doubled, okay? Come on, young men, let's go. We got the top six answers on the board. If y'all don't know these, we gonna stop playing. Which family member might be hard to get away from when they start talking?
Uncle.
Uncle. Let's go, Pastor. You gonna play.
We're playing. Come on.
Grace. What made you say uncle, man?
Because I'm talking about my uncle.
No, not that one.
That's my cousin.
Not that one.
That's my cousin.
That's your cousin.
That's my cousin.
But what? So your uncle over here, you just can't get away from him.
Yeah, when I see him, I have to just, you know, try and duck an eye or something.
He got all advice.
Lectures, all of that.
Lectures. Mm.
Yes.
It's too much.
Yeah. His life ain't even good as your life, but he know all about your life. Boy, let me tell you something. Sit down here, learn mm-hmm. yourself.
Yes.
Oh, man, what? Yeah. I got you. Grace?
Yes, sir.
Which family member might be hard to get away from when they start talking?
Your grandmother.
Your grandmother still living?
No, sir, unfortunately not.
Yeah. Okay. Your grandmother!
Celebrate.
We got no strikes, buddy. Which family member might be hard to get away from when they start talking?
Your mother, Steve. Your mother.
Yeah.
Your mother! Anthony, is your mom still living?
Yes, she is.
Yeah. She watched the show?
Yes, she is. She loves it, Mr. Harvey.
Oh, she love it?
Yes.
So you think she gonna love this answer you just gave?
Yeah, no, I mean.
Yeah.
She's still whooping me now and then. Just
huh?
Joking. I'm just joking.
This is all I heard. She's not going to whip me out of it now and then.
Get joking.
That's all I heard. I had no idea what Anthony said. I love you, man. You're one of my favorite people, man. Because you got a good spirit, man. You got a good spirit. You got a real good spirit.
Well, thanks, Mustafa.
Is he a happy person?
My man.
Do y'all answer any questions? Hell, y'all don't know what's on the board. You don't answer these questions. Is he a happy person?
Very much so, Mustafa.
Very much so?
Yes.
Okay, good. Is she a happy person?
No, she is, Mustafa.
No, she is.
Yes. No, she is a very, very happy person. I mean, and I'm responsible for that. She is.
Is it just me? Am I hearing the crazy stuff? Is she a very happy person? No, she is, Mr. Harvey.
I said, yes, she is.
You said, yes, she is.
Yes.
No, you said, no, she is first. Then you corrected and said, yes, she is. Because you don't listen, Anthony. See, Anthony, I listen very well. That's my job, is to listen. I meet people I don't know every day. That's why I love the show, because I meet family members and people. And I relate really well to families because I've been regular the majority of my life. People see me as this star, but no, man. I've been regular. I've done everything. So I'm able to relate.
Yes.
And I'm friendly, as long as you're friendly with me.
Yes.
But that's as all the Christianity I got
yes.
for you.
Yes.
You know, I don't
yes.
love my enemies and all that. I ain't worked up to that. You know, I ain't that good a Christian. You slap me, I'm slapping your ass right back. All right, El Marie, which family member might be hard to get away from when they start talking?
My daddy, Steve.
Your daddy.
Yes.
Hey, Jane, we still got no strikes. What family member hard to get away from when they start talking?
My brother, my elder brother.
Your elder brother. Bradley, we don't have any strikes. There's one answer on the board. Bradley, you give me this answer, man, you can clear the board. You knock it out the park. Bradley, which family member might be hard to get away from when they start talking?
My aunt.
Yeah. Your aunt. Everybody, it's the last round. And since you all have points, everyone here has everything to play for.
Yes.
Because now, whoever gets the most points at the end of this round will go on to play Fast Money for a chance at walking out of here with the jackpot of 75,000 rand. Yes. The Mofonge family got 84. Yes. The Malgas family got 259. Let's get it on. Give me Sambonga and give me Grace. All right, guys, here we go. In this round, the points have been tripled. Surveyed 100 people. Top 5 answers on the board. Everyone loves chicken, but which chicken dish is the most popular? Simbonye.
Chicken stew.
Chicken stew.
Yeah. Yeah.
Biryani.
Biryani. We're gonna play.
We're
gonna play.
Let's play. Let's play. Let's play. Let's play.
Anthony? Everybody loves chicken.
Yes.
Here, there, everywhere. But what is the most popular chicken dish?
Steve, I'm gonna say it's soft. and very clear. I would go with chicken wings.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to say it very soft to you. Me personally, I don't know all the answers.
Yes, yes.
But I don't see how chicken wings is a dish. It's just a piece of damn chicken. But if you want to say it softly, Anthony, I'm with you because you are my favorite. Yes. Chicken wings! I didn't think that was up there. This is not a dish. El Marie, only one strike. We're still in good shape. Everybody love chicken. What's the most popular chicken dish?
Chicken curry.
Yes!
Woo! Okay, Jane, only one strike. Everybody love chicken. What's the best chicken dish? What's the most popular chicken dish?
Grilled chicken.
Grilled chicken. Oh, grilled chicken.
Yeah.
Oh. Grilled chicken. All right, we got two strikes. Now listen to me, Bradley. We got to be careful. The Mofo Gang family can steal. We got two strikes. Everybody loves chicken, but what's the most popular chicken dish, Bradley?
Chicken a la king, which is...
Yes.
Chicken a la king. There's one answer left. Grace.
Yes, sir.
If it's there, you clear the board. Your family gets the points.
Yes, sir.
Your family wins the game and will be playing for a shot at 75,000 rand. But you have two strikes, Grace. If it's not there, the Mofokeng family can steal and they will win the game.
Yes.
Everyone loves chicken, but what chicken dish is the most popular?
Deep fried chicken.
This is for the win. I don't know nobody that don't like deep fried chicken. Yeah. Well, y'all played well though, man. Y'all really did, man. But nobody walks out of here empty-handed. So we're gonna triple your points and you're gonna take away 4,200 rand. Add a year's worth of KFC to the value of 10,000 rand. Well done, and I want to say thanks to all the folks at KFC for making this happen. Well, MOFOKENG family, I need two of you to play Fast Money. Come on, let's go right there. I got Anthony, I got Bradley. We're gonna play Fast Money, jackpot, 75,000 rand. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The MOFOKENG family won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fast Money!
All right, Anthony, this is how Fast Money works. Bradley's off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. We have enough time, we'll get back to it. You and Bradley together come with 200 points. Tell everybody what you'll win.
75,000 rand!
You just clear your throat. Oh, that's what yes. It is. Oh, no, it didn't work. You ready?
Yes, I am.
Twenty seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. Clock will start after I read the first question. All right, here we go. Name a font most people use on their work documents.
Times Roman. Times Roman.
Besides Johannesburg, name another major city in Mzansi.
Cape Town.
A type of tea.
Coffee.
Something you pack in your holiday suitcase.
My shoes.
A popular Valentine's Day gift.
Flowers.
Well, let's see how you did, Anthony. All right, here we go. Name a font most people use on their work documents. You said... That's what you said?
Yes.
Times New Roman. Survey said...
Yes!
Besides Johannesburg, name another major city in Mzansi. You said? Cape Town. Survey said? Yeah! A type of tea, you said?
Ribbles. It's fine.
Name a type of tea. Coffee. Survey said?
Ah. Should have said rooibos. I should have said rooibos.
You could have said anything but coffee. You could have said pee, and it would have made more sense. Okay, here we go. Something you pack in your holiday suitcase, you said? Shoes, survey said. Ah. A popular Valentine's Day gift, you said. Flowers, survey said. We'll be all right. We'll be all right. Come on, let's go. All right, let's bring out Bradley. Now, Bradley, that's your cousin.
Yeah, that's my cousin.
Yeah, he did okay. He did what he had to do. He got you halfway there. He got 107. You need 93 to win for okay. The jackpot of 75,000 Rand. Yeah. You really got to focus, man, to make this happen. That's a long way off, 93 points, okay? All right, I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate any of the answers. If you do, you're going to hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. It's gonna be a little bit, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we're gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Anthony's answers. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a font most people use on their work documents.
Arial.
Besides Johannesburg, name another major city in Mzansi.
Durban.
A type of tea.
Chai.
Something you pack in your holiday suitcase.
Clothes.
A popular Valentine's Day gift.
Flowers.
Try again.
Chocolate.
See how you did, Bradley. We need 93 points for 75,000 Rand. Name a font most people use on their work documents. You said Arial. Survey said? Arial was the number one answer. We need 60 points for 75,000 Rand. Besides Johannesburg, name another major city in Mzansi. You said? Durban. I've been there many times. Survey said? Cape Town. Cape Town was the number one answer. We need 41 points for 75,000 rand. A type of tea. You said chai. Survey said? What did you say you should have said, Anthony?
Rooibos.
Rooibos was the number one answer. We need 39 points. We need two good ones, y'all. We need two good ones. Something you pack in your holiday suitcase. You said clothes. Survey said.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
Clothes and underwear was the number one answer. We are 9 points away from 75,000 rand. A popular Valentine's Day gift, you said. Chocolates. Survey said. Roses and flowers was the number one answer. Well, congratulations to the MOFOKENG family. That's 75,000 rand. You got 75,000 rand, but you walk away with a grand total, 101,300 rand. Man, I'm Steve Harvey, everybody. We'll see you next time.